preparing today?
Today we're gonna cook a German potato salad, like from the south part of Germany, because we do it without the mayonnaise, and we're gonna make like a dressing, a vinaigrette with some beef stock, onions, vinegar, and some mustard, Dijon mustard I'm gonna use for this one. So it's more like a light version of a potato salad. So first step in this case, we have some salt. You can use rock salt, you can use normal already fine salt, up to you, also Himalaya salt. We're gonna put some salt in cold water. Cold water is important because if you put the potatoes in a water which is already warm, let's say hot or boiling, then they will start cooking on the outside and will not cook evenly, and in the center they will be still uncooked. So potatoes, washed potatoes, try to use the same size so they cook all evenly and at the same time, and this is also really important, otherwise you have the same problem in terms of overcooking. Also put some caraway seeds in the potatoes, which I don't have at the moment. It's not so common here in Qatar in the supermarket and the market to get it, so I keep it out, but it's also not really necessary. You can make it with or without. It's of course the flavor will be more nice if you use caraway seeds, but today we make mainly important is the salt. Put it on medium heat from the gas and then start letting them boil slowly. For the dressing, just take an onion. You can use a white onion, you can use a red onion. You can also use the shallots. Shallots is also a good option because they are like less spicy, less sharp than a normal onion. But also for the potato salad, you can use nice white onion. Then we're gonna chop the onion, or let's say cut it in punoas. Punoas means like fine small cubes, having a sharp knife. Then, really important, why you do that, watch your fingers. I'll show you in a bit. Then you cut it like this. And same with the second one. Then you can like this, or you go like this. It's up to you. In the beginning, better maybe like this. It's better. And then when you have the onion coming here, you're gonna cut like this, and this way, and this way. So you have almost no wastage. And then just again, it's more or less not really chopping, it's more like cutting. Now we're gonna make the dressing for the salad. Also marination, it's a marination dressing, you can call it either way. We have some corn oil or sunflower oil you can use. Don't use olive oil, because olive oil will be too much overpowering than also the flavor of the potatoes, and with the mustard it will be not like, I mean, it's not really a Mediterranean dish, it's like a German dish, like from, especially from our area, so it's not that we are using olive oil for the salad. Then you have like your finely chopped onions, put it into the pot or into a saute pan or whatever you have at home. Like, don't put too much in the beginning, full heat, like medium heat, or when you see it's getting too hot, then you reduce the heat, because you don't want to give any color to the onions. You want to keep them nice shiny, but not kind of like giving them a brown color, to keep the flavor, just like to have just the onion flavor, not like roasting flavors or something. Then you sweat them for a little bit, just keep them all flatten out, so they can get from everywhere the same heat. Not always like steaming too much. I know it looks cool or whatever, but it's not really necessary, because it will also take then much longer for the onions to cook. So then when the onions are having this kind of stage, like when they are a bit like this already shiny, then they are okay. So they are now, I would say, halfway or a bit more than halfway cooked. Then we're gonna add some beef stock. I use beef stock, you can also use chicken stock, you can also use a vegetable stock. But for this one, the nicest thing is to use a beef stock. Fill this one in, and then also straight after, some white vinegar. Then we also add one piece of bay leaf. I like to add a bay leaf, gives it a nice flavor. It's, everybody has his own preferences. So I put a bit of a bay leaf. Gives it this extra nice touch. Then you can also use fresh bay leaf. I use the dry ones because they are more easy to get. You get everywhere in the supermarket, so also back in Germany. Then some Himalaya salt and some, I use now black pepper. Ideally you use white pepper, but anyway, in the end, doesn't make a big difference. I mean, black pepper is more intense than the white pepper, but also with the color. But today we have the black pepper. Also some black pepper. So for the vinegar that you are gonna use to fill up the, or to add into the stock, you need to have a white vinegar, which is like a high acidity, like really sour, which is not too sweet, because later on, when the potatoes, they're gonna absorb a lot of from this sourness. So if you have a vinegar which is not so sour, then it will be really blunt flavor. So it's not really nice, so that's why. Now the stock starts with the boiling. What I'm gonna do now, I will switch it off. And then I will add some mustard. I'm gonna add some Dijon mustard. Now I added 3 teaspoons of Dijon mustard. You can also use some other mustards, like English mustard, but for this particular version of the salad, best is Dijon mustard, because it's having just like not too much different other flavors being with himself. Also, I add a bit more salt and a little bit more pepper, but mainly the salt because of the potatoes. Again, they will take a lot of flavor in themselves, and then it's gonna be under seasoned otherwise. Really important now is also don't boil it anymore. Just keep it off the heat, the dressing, the marination. Otherwise the mustard will start kind of like it looks like cloudy when you keep on boiling it again. The salad dressing is gonna be complete now. It's done like this. So just keep it on the side, that it stays hot, and the potatoes need to cook a little bit more until 75-80%, and then we just will take them out of the water, let them cool down, and while they are cooling down, we're gonna peel them. So they need to stay hot when we mix it together with the marination, the salad dressing. Now we have some fresh chives. I just cut them off. We have here like this little pot, basically everywhere available. This one I just on a bit like cold rinsing water. Then you put them on a bit like a kitchen paper. You can also use a kitchen towel, whatever you have at home. And then make them dry. Then you put them on the cutting board. Put them the other way, like this. Then you cut a little bit the tips off, and then you just make nice small chive rings. Watch your fingers all the time. You can check the potatoes. Potatoes are cooked when they come off the knife like this. But as we make a salad out of them, so it means we will not reheat them anymore. We need to cook them still a little bit more. So the potatoes need to be cooked to 80-85%. Because once you take them out from the water, they will still keep on more cooking because of they will still keep some heat in them. So that's why we're gonna cook them until they're almost soft. And then the potatoes are now cooked enough. So we will turn off the gas or the power, depends what you have. Then we take them out onto a plate. You can also put them you can strain them in the sink, and then just keep them on the side to cool a little bit down. But they need to stay hot for the when you're gonna mix the salad with the dressing, because it's gonna be that the starch of the potatoes will basically become like it makes it really creamy. In Germany we say schlotzig. That means it's gonna be like fluffy and really nice creamy, even without cream in the salad. Potatoes I put here. Here I have a small bowl with some cold water. And here the bowl where I put the potatoes in. I put some gloves on because the potatoes are still freshly boiled, so they are still proper hot. And yes, I'm a chef, but it's even too hot for me. Then a small paring knife, and then you just basically peel them. So you can see when the potatoes are still hot, they're really easy to peel. And also later for the, when you're gonna mix it with the dressing, with the marination, they observe the liquid properly, and then with the starch it will become nice, creamy, and very delicious. If you want to keep them a little bit to cool a bit more down, you can do that. So then you can also do it without the gloves. You can also do it now without the gloves, but I make a bet anybody who is doing without the gloves now, even a chef, will probably have some difficulties because they are still boiling hot. So now, once we're done with the potatoes, peeling them, this one you're going to put aside. Potatoes you have here, and then you will just basically cut them into discs like this. The size, that thick is gonna be perfect. Actually, you can also make it a bit more thick, it's up to you. But this one is gonna be nice also later on when you're gonna eat it to enjoy them nice. Don't cut them too thin, because if you cut them too thin, then later on when we start mixing it with the marination, with the dressing, it will become too much like meshy, like mashed potatoes. But it will start getting a little bit kind of like breaking the discs, but that's gonna be okay, because then you also can see it starts getting really nice creamy and it starts binding. Now, the last step, basically just to finish it off with the stock, with the marination dressing. I just put it again the heat on to keep it nice hot. The potatoes are still really nice hot. And then you put little by little some stock. In the beginning, don't put too much stock, or dressing in this case. Don't put too much from the dressing in the beginning, because you want to keep it like this. Starts binding. Because of the potato starch, what I mentioned earlier, so they stay hot and then nice emulsifying with the dressing, and then you have this already see coming, this nice creamy texture from the potato salad. And some more of the stock in the beginning, not all at the same time, otherwise it will be more like a soup, and then you will face difficulties to get it nicely mixed up and getting the creaminess. Now this one is already enough liquid. It depends the amount of potatoes you have, and then also you can make it like however you want to have after your own taste. You can put more vinegar, you can put less vinegar, you can put more mustard, less mustard. It depends. You can keep it more dry, you can make it more liquidy. That's all up to you. But basically the texture, it should be like, is I would say like this. So now we just leave it a little bit more resting, and then with the starch it will become more creamy. And then we will continue and finish it off with the chives in a little bit. Now potato salad is done. You can either put the chives already in the salad, but I choose maybe the more nice option. I'm gonna put it in the plate and then a little bit garnishing on top. And then later on when you eat it, you're gonna mix it into the salad. So it gives it a bit like this nice extra flavor of oniony flavor. And also this a bit like more freshness. And also because you serve the potato salad always warm, or at least in room temperature, the chives will start getting gray once you put them straight into the salad. So that's why better you put them on top, and then it's like garnish and kind of like a condiment at the same time. And that's it. Enjoy this lovely salad. That's it for today with our delicious potato salad, which we made for you. And I hope you like the video. I hope much more you like and enjoy the potato salad. Try it at home also. It's really easy and simple, and It's good for a side dish, for like different other things like a veal schnitzel or like some sausages, whatever you want to have it on the side, or even just as a proper main course by itself. And yeah, have a good one, take care, and hope to see you soon again.
And guys, if you haven't subscribed yet on our YouTube channel, please do subscribe and hit the notification bell para updated kayo whenever we upload new videos. And see you on the next one. Bye!
Bye! Tschüss!
So let's taste the potato salad.
Mmm.